Hey, what's going on, everyone? Chad, like I said, welcome to yet another episode of The Hive at A&M Entertainment. I'm your boy, question one and only, Sexy Shay, and I have the lovely Ms. Nada. How are you all doing today? So, I hope you guys are having a great week, because my week so far has been, it's been okay. Like I said, I moved
Exciting.
and
New things going on.
yeah, I had to move. So as you all know, I'm in a completely different setting. And like I said, it's come along pretty well. So, it's been nice. I'm loving our nice little bougie home now. As I told Nada off screen.
It's very O'Shea. It's a very O'Shea place.
Yes, and I love it. And I'm like, this is exactly what I need right now for sure. So on today's episode of The Hive, we're gonna do a little recap of our review from Superman, Man of Tomorrow, and then we're gonna touch bases on some set photos that came out from The Batman. As you all know, The Batman has resumed filming in Liverpool, and of course, it has been pushed to March of 2022, so it's now a spring film instead of a October Halloween film now. Due to, that the dreadful bitch COVID. She's just
She's the real
freaking,
villain.
she's freaking everything out. Yes, she's the real villain, okay? She's real villain for sure. She needs to go away. And then a little extra casting news from Black Adam. So here we go. Nada on Superman Man of Tomorrow. Care to let the audience know a little recap from that film. Oh, by the way, this is spoiler, so if you haven't seen it, click away, and if you don't care, well, by all means, keep watching.
If they haven't seen it, it means they haven't watched our last video.
Facts, see that part.
So that's also a problem. So go back and check out our last video where we did an in-depth review of Superman Man of Tomorrow. But short story, long story short, it tells the coming of age tale of Clark Kent, how he becomes Superman. He's a young Superman in this particular film, Lobo and Parasite. Yeah,
Yeah,
Lobo, Parasite,
Parasite.
Lex Luthor are the main villains. And this introductory story is we prefer this over the Man of Steel that we got. We feel like this is the movie that we deserve to see on screen. With a confident Clark Kent, there were
Right.
times he doubted himself, but he went to his father, Jonathan, and Jonathan gave him good advice, unlike what we saw in the Man of Steel
Now,
film.
still,
So
Tommy can't that one.
we're loving and supportive. But they also let Clark know there was consequences to the choices that he made, and it was
Is
just
that
up
part right
to
there?
him to live and deal with the consequences. So Superman wins, the bad guys go away, Earth
And
is saved.
there's no casualties. There's no half destroyed metropolis and stuff.
Correct.
Collateral damage.
So that's the recap. We gave it, I believe we gave whiffs. We gave it lips. It was a score of
Yes, our rating system is based on lips because me and Ollie, we got some juicy ass lips, people. So, listen, I think I gave it, pretty sure I gave it a five out of five lips, right?
I think we both gave it 5 out of 5.
Yeah,
It was
like we
good.
had
It
some,
was good.
yeah, like we had some minor critiques here and there, but it was a good anime film. So yes, you guys, we do highly recommend that you do check out the anime film. Also, it's in the new film in the new DC anime universe post the New 52 universe that concluded with Justice League Dark Apocalypse War. That's which of course that's a pretty good film too
It was
as
a very
well.
good film. The ending was
A
kind
nice
of ambiguous, but it also signaled something new was coming because Flash was going to reset the timeline again,
yeah,
which is
do another
bad.
flashpoint.
Which is why we're here now. They're
And
releasing
in
new films.
yeah and in the Superman Man of Tomorrow film, they also established that Batman does exist in that world and he's already active. So yeah, there's a little Batman Easter egg in there as well.
I'm just curious as to how they're going to bring our girl into that universe whenever her film comes out.
A Wonder Woman.
Yeah.
I mean, her influence was already in the New 52 universe. Like, because remember, Wonder Woman's like warrior armor was literally patterned right after Gal Gadot's Wonder Woman outfit. Like, it's so crazy how so many animated films, these animated films and clothing lines and everything was patterned and made right after post Wonder Woman that came out in 2017. Like, that film has made such a huge impact in the whole cultural community and also comic book fans and superhero fans alike. So,
but how do you think they're going to bring her into this new animated universe? Because this reset the timeline. Flash reset the timeline after the Apocalypse War, whatever the name of that was. Okay, so he reset it, right? So we know Batman's there because they made mention of Batman on one or two occasions in the Superman film. They've established Superman, which I think was a good idea to start with the number one hero that you have, which is Superman. Mm. They made
Exactly. Hear that, WB? Look at Superman of Tomorrow. Give us the sequel.
Look at what DC Animation is doing, and let's mimic that, you know what I'm saying, in live action. Right. So I'm curious as to... So I told you earlier today I was able to catch, what was it, Batman Death in the Family, which came out a few days ago, actually. You know, it was released, and I told you I was surprised by how short the film was, but basically just tells the story of the birth of Red Hood, where he came from and his relationship with Batman. And the whole, well, I'm not going to spoil that. But my next question is, so now they've done...
P.S. It's not that long. It's only 30-some minutes, so
it's just 30 let you know minutes. That. I wanted more, but it is what it is. But so they...
If you want more to Nada's disappointment, if you want more, go rewatch the actual Batman Under the Red Hood. There's a film right there. This is literally filling in all the exposition that was left out of that film that came back, like, what, 2010, I think?
I know, but we don't want to look back. We're moving forward, right? So we're moving forward with the new
Nada, film. If that was the case, then we would not be talking about the Snyder Cut right now. You're talking about moving backwards. Hell.
In all fairness, you brought that up and not me. I was trying to stay away from that topic.
It was bound to happen anyway, so it's fine. We've already established. We don't really. That's true. That's fine. Fine. We'll move forward then. Let's not go there.
So as I was leading to was you got Superman, you got Batman, and how do they bring Wonder Woman into this new version, the reset timeline? How do you think they're going to introduce her? Presumably, she'll have the next film, I think. Presumably,
maybe. If to introduce Wonder Woman in this new animation style as well, in this new animation universe, I would say they can probably... To be honest, they can basically kind of keep... they can do a similar design for Gal Gadot's Wonder Woman armor on the film, if they don't do it like that. And or they could just straight up do the Wonder Woman costume, Wonder Woman lookalike rebirth, right? Because doesn't the Wonder Woman rebirth have like pants on?
You know what I don't want is Wonder Woman with pants on. I did not like that iteration, so I would not like to see that. I just wonder what story do you think they're gonna... I mean, obviously there's a reset, but like, these characters have already kind of been around, but I guess they have to start over again with the origins.
I think they can do the same thing with Batman. I mean, Wonder Woman's been around literally forever, so you can just say she has left the island, but she's there. Or you like Batman, or the second thing is, you be like Batman, she's just active in some other parts of a city, like DC, for example. Yeah. You're good. I'm just saying, have her in DC if she's already left the island and established. As far as costume or armor, you can say either pattern it after Gal Gadot's Wonder Woman from the films, or if they want, they can go real old school or OG and do the swimsuit the swimsuit from the Justice League animated TV series that came on like in the early 2000s. Yeah, because I don't know. All you guys out there, checking out Wonder Woman, her swimsuit outfit, and Linda Carter. So, yeah, you can either do... yeah, that's what... Yeah, there you go. He's the OG.
In all fairness, they did bring back the red tights for Superman, so they could be going retro and then eventually moving him forward fashion.
Yeah, yeah, they can lay bring back the swimsuit version of her armor, even though the swimsuit version is literally she's wearing three pieces of armor and the rest is just cloth. It's with magic. Some heels on.
It's magic.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Enough said.
Bless her heart. Well, the only thing that I would want to know is what type of origin you would give her. So are you still sticking with the New 52 that she's the daughter of Zeus? Or are you sticking with the original where she's made of clay and blessed by the gods?
They kind of did a hybrid in the comics where they say, you know, we knew, well, okay, they changed it in the comics. They changed it from her being clay, but that was part of her story for a little while. And then she found out what her true heritage was. So then she had a coming of age story in the comics. So they could, that way you still kind of tie in both themes at the same time. I'm not saying this is what it used to be, but this is what it is now. So I think that they could do something along those lines. I want to see her... I mean, if we're doing like a reset and everybody's being introduced again, I want to see her come on the scene like in a huge fashion, right? Kind of like she did with BVS a little bit.
Like a grand entrance, like a nice... Yeah. Okay. So yeah.
Because like the Batman Death and the Family had Clark Kent. It didn't have Superman, but it had Clark Kent because you never saw him as Superman. So something like, because they're already tying the movies together just with like cameos like that, like in the Man of Tomorrow, they talked about Batman, his cape, which inspired Martha to make Clark's cape. And then so in this one, Batman is talking to Superman about the birth of Red Hood, and then some kind of way you can have them both somewhere in Wonder Woman's film. So then it kind of ties stuff together. I mean, that's what I like to see. Obviously, we don't write the story, so I'm just excited to see where the DC animated universe is going. I like the animation style. It's kind of old school, but I appreciate
it. Does. It reminds me of the Superman anime series animation style when I watched it as a kid. I was like, oh, okay.
No, it's good. It's nice. Good. So brings back a little nostalgia. I think they're going for a lighter, you know, content and material this time around because it got really
dark. Yeah.
It was Justice League Dark. You know what I'm saying? That was the last film of that particular arc. So we're going to go a lighter route, and then I'm sure they'll get dark as it progresses, and then they'll reset again and just keep going from there.
Yeah, I mean, same thing in movies. You have the actors play the character as much as they can, and when they get too old, well, recast them. Yeah, exactly. Hit the reset button, snap them away, or if they feel like they want to retire from that particular role, and then that too. So,
is there any other character? Obviously, the main seven we all look forward to, but is there any other character that you would want to see in DC Animated Universe? Maybe someone that is a favorite of yours that we really don't get to see a whole lot of?
Sorry, guys. There's something in my eye. To be honest, as far as DC, my favorite character is pretty much the Trinity, so I'm pretty much covered. Let's go. I mean, to be honest, if they introduce Green Lantern, you can bring in Jon Stewart because I feel like he was kind of like left on the back end in the last universe where he was like he'll come because like when you watch Justice League Dark with Batman, he was in that film for like maybe a few minutes and then he was in Justice League Dark Apocalypse War and then he got wrecked, he got incinerated. So the whole Green Lantern old speech chain still didn't work.
Yeah,
got fried. So I would say you can probably do like one nostalgia, introduce Jon Stewart Green Lantern like they did in the Justice League anime series
and stick with him for a while, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like, let him just come in and say that, oh, he's just substituting for Hal Jordan. Nah, stick with him for a while.
We need him to be there for a while because we want to see his side, you know, his story. Let that unfold because you can bring in who was it, Vixen?
Yeah.
And Hawkgirl. I mean, if you look at the animated series, he was involved with both of them. So you can also use that as a gateway to bring them in, expand the animated universe anyway. But enough of the anime talk, we do have more news to discuss with y'all. We have information from the Batman.
The Batman. Hey, of course, I'm sure the Batman is on everyone's radar because everyone was just orgasming from that trailer that happened that came out from DC fandom. I know I was. I ain't gonna lie. I'm sorry. I couldn't fight my fanboyism. And no, people, it wasn't because of that one action scene. No. I loved what everything Matt Reeves was saying. I liked the style he was going for, the tone, everything. Of course, the action, obviously. You know, who doesn't love eye candy? And then I like that where he is taking the story because, you know, going a detective route of Batman more so than the previous Batman that films that we've have grown accustomed to since Bale. Mm-hmm. So with the Batman, like I said, they've resumed filming in Liverpool. So it looks like they're still filming on location. But I also believe that because COVID is still in effect, they'll still do like the soundstage thing that, you know, the Tim Burton Batman films did. You know, do like that if need be. And I also saw, so in the set photos, which I wish I could bring them up for you, but, you know, I don't know. For some odd reason, my thing is not loading enough. So I'm like, so I said the hell with it. So, but I'm sure everyone has already seen them. Anyway, in the set photos for those of you at home.
There, I can do a screen share while you're talking. Is that okay?
Yeah, can you do that? Yeah, can you do it real quick? So real quick. So I'm seeing the set photos. They reveal Bruce Wayne. So Robert Pattinson's Bruce Wayne. Revealed Colin Farrell's Penguin, who's unrecognizable. Like the prosthetics and makeup they did on him is crazy. Like they should give him they should give the crew who did that an award. That's incredible work they did on him. They also did John Turturro, is that his name is, for Carmine Falcone. Mm-hmm.
Perfect choice.
As well as Zoe Kravitz's Catwoman. Mm-hmm. Yep, you can see that right there.
Yeah. This picture doesn't show you the full outfit because her full outfit is nice. I will.
Yeah. For example, on Variety magazine or Insider, you can look up. You guys, look at the full set photos on there. I'm liking Zoe Kravitz's Catwoman book in her funeral attire. Yeah, clear, because you can see that's a wig, because in the trailer.
Clearly.
Or in the film, she has the short hair Selena Kyle look. And then, you know, you have Carmine Falcone, mm-hmm. where if you notice on the right side of his face, he has the claw mark, so clearly he has had a run-in with Catwoman before. Mm-hmm. And I believe that was also taken from the comics from Long Halloween, that Catwoman actually scratches his face. So there you go. Are you diehard comic fans? Hello, Matt Reeves. He's barring straight from the source material, so there is no reason. And he's just adding his own flavor to it. So, you know, come on, people. Okay. You can just move on from Twilight. He's did other films besides that. As far as, you know, Pattinson's Bruce Wayne in these set photos, as well as him driving the car. To be honest, the more I look at him in his Bruce Wayne look, it's growing on me more.
I would agree. I didn't like it at first because I thought it was too emo. But I think kind of fit with the mood of the entire film, especially after seeing that trailer at DC fandom.
The more I look at it, I was like, oh, okay. I was like, I'm warming up more to it. I was like, okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So I can dig a little bit. He's younger.
Yeah.
Figuring it out. So yeah, I'm good with it.
Yeah. Which is why I feel as though I think I kind of let that part slide, only because I know this is a younger Batman. He's only his second year being Batman, so he's not fully seasoned like Bale and Affleck already. So, but hopefully maybe towards the end of the film or so, or the second or the sequel, he'll have the more slick back, updo, nicer hairstyle. But we'll see.
More distinguished. He's kind of rough around the edges right now.
Yeah, he hasn't found his still a little niche yet. Yeah, he hasn't found his niche yet. I'm sure he'll get there throughout the first film. Which I feel like with all these villains and Rose Gallery up in here, I feel like this film's going to be almost 3.5 hours. Like, I would not be surprised if this film will be the same length as Dark Knight Rises. That was like, what, 240?
Long.
Yeah, long.
Well, I mean, if the story's good, the action's good, you really won't mind. You know what I mean?
Yeah, so, exactly.
And I agree with you. With the number, the Rose Gallery that they're going to have, to do them justice, the movie's going to have to be longer than 2.5 hours. Going to have to be. And that's
I say about 240, 245 at the most. That should be enough time to introduce the Rose Gallery and set them up for, you know, the future sequels like that. Because on the side of, like I said, you already know you got Penguin, you got Riddler. Riddler's the main guy. You got Catwoman, who she plays both sides depending on how she feels. I feel like that's how I see it. Then you got who else? Penguin, Riddler, Catwoman. Oh, they also said Firefly is supposed to be in this film as well. Firefly, and also I believe they also casted the Mad Hatter.
That's a for one film.
I told you not. I'm telling you, the Long Halloween. He's literally taking huge elements from that according to this film. So, you know, as the first Batman film. In the new universe is like, you know, I say, but the thing is, you know, Matt Reeves, he's done the eighth film, the last two eight films, so I'm sure he can handle multiple characters in the film. Well,
you know, to go back to our earlier conversation about where we talked about the Snyder Cut, I think it's like with Snyder, my issue with that with Justice League and kind of how he developed the universe was he put everything out there at one time. It was just like 5, 6, 7 years worth of stuff he just kind of threw out there at one time. However, I see Matt Reeves doing something similar with this Batman film because he's introducing Batman and like his entire Rose Gallery. But I think it's still going to be focused enough where it's not going to feel like it's too much. It's not going to feel like a jumbled mess. So
right.
I'm curious to see how that's going to play out because it seems like there's a very distinct theme that he's following. And I think, I hope, and it's seeing some of his other films, I feel like he can pull this off. So I'm very excited. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And like, and to that point, like you said, I'm seeing a lot of elements of The Long Halloween as well as the sequel comic, The Dark Victory, which is why I feel as though we might get a live action Robin, like the Flying Graysons. It is a cameo or something like that. Because, you know,
it's time.
And you know, now that to be honest, since we're on stuff, just real quick, I feel like it's time to bring in the Bat Family. You have a young Batman. I think it's time because, you know, and with today's technology and how they make superhero suits, you can make work where it doesn't look cheesy and too serious. Like, you know, Bale was his own separate universe and based on legit realism. And then you got Affleck. Well, I mean, his Batman's hella old, and his Bat Family is probably retired. They're going on their own thing, and villains are already old and retired too, or dead. So, I mean,
so do you want to see the Bat Family cameo in Batman films, or you want to see a Bat Family film? Just the whole family.
I say for right now, do like cameos, and then maybe towards the third or fourth film, you can actually have them in the film with him. Like at least have them exist in his universe. Come on, and then you know after Flashpoint, when you incorporate this Batman to with everybody else,
he'll bring
make more sense. Yeah, exactly.
I got you. I support that.
Mm-hmm. So, not to strain too much on that part, but that's little news about the Batman. You know, not much news due to COVID, but segueing to our last topic, we have a little casting news from Black Adam. So, Nada, care to explain to us what this casting news is about?
Yes, yes. I just read this news today. So they have casted the villain for Black Adam, and it's going to be a character by the name of Sabacc. And I hope I'm saying that correctly. It's S-A-B-B-A-C. And his name is an amalgamation. It's an acronym of all the evil baddies. So let me run down this list. So the S is for Satan. The A is for Elim. B is for Belial. The other B is for Beelzebub. We all know who that is. last A is for Asmodeus. And the last letter C, which is Kratos. And these are all demons of hell. So very similar to...
So Jody, I don't know if you're going to be able to see this film. we know that you don't like devilish satanic stuff like that. So, you know...
Let me pull up this picture and show you just how serious this guy is going to look. Hold on. Check out that. This guy, if that doesn't say devil, I don't know what does say devil. Okay? This guy looks B-A-D.
Oh, shoot.
You see what I'm talking about?
Sure. Is that Lucifer himself?
that's old. That's Lucifer's cousin right there, but you know.
Oh, so okay. His more ripped cousin.
Yeah. He's a little more in shape. This is the one we like to see on the film. This is gonna be
right. This one. Oh yeah. See now the you know when I see this and what we heard so far about Black Adam, I don't think no one is mentally ready for this film in terms of the action, the look of it, everything. I don't think no one's ready for it. You got Adam Smasher, and they just confirmed that he's gonna be as big as the Eiffel Tower.
Hey, I'm ready for it. I want to see it. I also need to show you the actor who's gonna be playing our favorite villain demon.
Sabacc.
Yeah, I got a little sidetrack with the picture. So bear with me, please. Let me find this guy's photo. His name is Marwan Kenzari. I believe he played in Aladdin. Because his name sounds familiar. So I think this is the guy from Aladdin. So let's get his picture up here and show y'all what we're looking with. And I don't want to pull that picture up. Hold on one second. Okay, you can play in the crowd while I find a good photo of this gentleman.
Cool.
You can take a shirt off. You can always do that in flex.
No, not yet. I had to get my place all nice and more spruced up first. Then again, this might just be the final product because, like I said, I'm not one for a lot of decor. So most I'll do is make, huh?
I said that's what we're going to get from you? About the decor. Yeah. You said you're not one for a lot of decor, so you're going to keep it minimal?
Yeah, probably. I might get like some nice, you know, portraits and just hang up on the wall somewhere like that. Like I said, I'm still waiting on my entertainment section here. Cause like I have a TV, my plasma screen TV, which is it's a new one. So it's and when I'm gaming, it looks real nice. Cause my
for you.
Okay, cool.
I apologize for the delay, everyone. Let me see. Let's pull this up and see. Tell me what you think. So I thought this guy looked familiar. Can you see my screen now? Am I sharing with you? I think so.
I'm about to give it a few minutes. Okay. Give it a second.
So this gentleman looks familiar because he was in... Oh, God. What's that film that came out on Netflix? Oh, my God. I'm looking at it right now. I'm looking at the... Jesus. The one with Charlize Theron, where they were gods, and they live forever, and God, what was the movie?
Hancock?
No, not Hancock. It just came out on Netflix this past summer.
Okay, I don't know. I don't watch TV.
Anyway, so this is Marwan Kenzari. This is him close shaven. This is him with a full beard. So this is going to be our villain for Black Adam.
Sabacc.
Who is just the devil. So just as Shazam calls his powers and he gets his powers from all these gods or whatever, Sabacc calls on these names. He says Sabacc. And Ooh. He gets powers from all these demons from hell.
Oh, he cute. Wait a minute. How you doing, Marvin?
Oh. It's really not even one I wanted to show you. Like, he had another picture on there, but we got to...
No, we can stick with this one.
Yeah. Old guard. Oh. So, if you look to the right of his photo, this is him with a full beard. And this is mm-hmm. him film The Old Guard, which came out this past summer on Netflix. It was a really good film. Maybe we'll talk about that sometime down the line, maybe not on DC Talk, but it was a really good film. So that is, if you recall his face, that is where you know him from. But he is going to be coming to the DC universe. He's going to be coming as the big bad villain for Black Adam.
I mean, shoot, I'm ready. Like you said, I'm ready. You're ready. Bring it on. I just feel no one else is ready to see this film. Like he said, I believe The Rock when he says it's going to change a lot of things of the universe going forward, you know. So
I tend to believe The Rock when he lays it out there.
It's pretty much fact. When he says it's
real live superhero. Like, we know how the Fast and Furious went, where they and Hobbs and Shaw, when they were.
And their craziness. And so you already know the actions. He's going to bring the action. He's going to bring it.
It's going to be insane. And I'm ready for it. And we'll fill Jody in on it, you know, leaving out the minor aspects of it. But we will really watch it more than once and fill him in on how the movie was and how those characters were. And I'm just totally excited about it. We're moving in the right direction finally. You know, Rona, that dusty...
That dusty ass bitch. Just he's going away. She's messing up everything. Like, we could have so many movies right now. We could have 1/84 by now. We could have been talking about that. Been talking about that. It was already October. Mm-hmm. But let me not go off on tangent right now. We just gotta be patient and just keep covering as many DC news as much as possible. But sorry, guys, kind of ran over just a little bit, but you know what? Hey, listen, when it comes to DC stuff, we can go on for hours if you want to. But as always, you can always tune in to The Hive every Saturday at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And I'm your boy, Sexy Shay. This is your love, Nada, and we're out. We're back.
Okay, back again.
Well, hi.